Kids learning their multiplication facts is something that's pretty challenging. And so I want to give you some advice. And I've now been through three kids doing it this way. So I feel fairly confident that it's a good system, and I want to share it with you. So, first of all, people want to know, when do I start working on multiplication with my child? My suggestion is wait until it's introduced in your chosen curriculum. As soon as it's introduced, I would start using the computer program called Table Fables. So it's tablefables.net, and it is a British company that has made it. So the default might be in British pounds, but you can change it to dollars. And this is the most effective computer game I have ever tried for multiplication. I have tried a lot. I've tried free ones, I have paid for different ones. So I've tried a lot of different ones. This one is super effective. It teaches up to 12 times 12. And the way that it works is each number is a character and there's a little story for every single math fact. So it's like a very silly story. A lot of times it will not make any sense at all, but it's memorable and that's why it works. So as soon as your child starts multiplication in their curriculum, get Table Fables. Get it for like 6 months. And just start having them do table fables every day along with your math curriculum. Because you can do table fables just for like 5 to 15 minutes a day, depending on how long each little day's challenge takes. But anyway, I have more to say about table fables separately. And I also probably still have, depending on when you're watching this video, I might still have a coupon code. So I'm going to put the coupon code in the comments below. But it's seriously the best I've ever seen. So do that for 12 times 12. Then, if you do CC, you have to go up to 15 times 15. So then the question is, how do we conquer those extra facts that aren't in Table Fables? The number one thing that I, or the first thing I want you to do is I want you to print a chart, a 15 times 15 chart. Just go Google times tables 15 times 15 chart. You'll find one, print it, and color in all the facts that your child already knows. This is going to be a really helpful visual for you and for your child, because math facts have the commutative property, right? If you know 6 times 7, you also know 7 times 6. So getting it colored and seeing, oh, look at that, you know almost all of them already. It's going to feel so much less daunting than not doing that. So the visual is super helpful. Plan on conquering the 13s after the 12s. Like the first thing you should do in going up to 15s is the 13s. And that's because if they know their 12s, all they have to do is add one more. Like if you're doing 5 times 12 is 60, then 5 times 13 is just one more 5, 65, right? And it's totally fine to use strategies like that. So have your kids think about those things. Okay, 2 times 12 is 24, so 2 times 13 would just be one more 2, so 26. Okay, I got that. So have your kids work through the 13s that way. Then I suggest tackling the 15s because they all end in fives and zeros. It's slightly easier. And then last but not least, tackling the 14s. I do not have any tricks for the 14s. You're just gonna have to bang it out. How do we bang it out though, right? That's your next question. The CC flashcards. These are about the only flashcards you can find out there other than Etsy. You can find them on Etsy. I went that route 1 year and I cut them, but they're not as nice as these like thin, you know, laminated kind of cards, but they have a purpose too. So do whatever you want, but definitely you're gonna need some flashcards to really keep working on these multiplication facts. Another key is don't, if you're a CC person, don't wait until January of the year they're 10 to start working on their multiplication facts. That's rough. That's a lot. It can be done and it can be done successfully, but if you can, start your kid much earlier. Literally, as soon as it's introduced in their math curriculum, start working on it. Do table fables. Add in the flashcards and make it a part of your week. So, I have a 10-year-old, he's brand new 10, and I have an 8-year-old. So, with both of them, we do the CC flashcards every week. So, the 10-year-old, I do the entire deck once a week, and we do it in two sittings. So, one day I do this side of the whole deck, And then the next day, I do this side of the entire deck. So he's not having to sit for the whole entire deck. Starting in January, when Memory Master time is approaching quicker, I'm going to do the entire deck front and back just once a week because he is just brushing up on things. Like he has already mastered all these facts, so he's just brushing up on it. So that's how we do it. For the 8-year-old, who it's totally fine that he does not know all of his facts. This is what my 8-year-old knows. So he's still got a lot of holes, but I'm okay with it because he's only 8. So what I do for him is he does half of the CC flashcards once a week. So same thing. I do half of the deck, and one day I do the front of that half. The next day I do the back of that half. So it takes him 2 weeks to go through the whole deck. And it's not technically the whole deck because I've pulled out a lot of the facts he doesn't know yet because I have the luxury of doing it slower, I'm not trying to add in all the facts he doesn't know right now. Instead, I'm adding them in one at a time. Every few weeks, I'll add one in. And then when he comes to it and he's like, I don't know that one. Then we kind of just do a quick, like, 7 times of a repeat of that one. You know, 2 times 3 is 6. 2 times 3 is 6. 2 times 3 is 6. What's 2 times 3? It's six. Like, obviously, it's not that one because that one's really easy. But we just say it over and over again. And then we keep going. And eventually he will remember it. My 10-year-old, about 6 months ago, he had about 10 facts that they weren't sticking with these methods. And he really wanted this remote control car. And so I said, dude, if you memorize these facts, I will give you $20. And darn if he didn't have those memorized in about 3 days. So I did my due diligence and I said, okay, I'm gonna quiz you now. And then we're gonna wait 2 days. I'm gonna quiz you again because I need to make sure they're really in there, not just like memorize them at the last second, which really isn't deep in your mind. But I want you to prove to me that you've gotten them deep in your mind, and then I'll give you your $20. And he did it. And he just used flashcards, but he owned it for those few days, and he really practiced because he was super motivated by the money. So honestly, motivating your kids with something that they want will help them learn some of the facts that maybe are the toughest for them to learn. And I think everyone has those few math facts that are just like, they're just tough to remember. I still have lots of holes. I don't know up to 15 times 15, but as far as up for my 12 times 12, I've got certain ones that I just like, you know, still to this day, I just can't remember them very well. So anyway, so the takeaways are, do table fables as soon as your child is introduced to multiplication in their curriculum. Then start adding the CC flashcards and adding those facts, 13s, 14s, and 15s. Add them slowly. Because this is assuming you're starting when your kids are like 8 or 9, not quite 10. Because by the time they're 10 and trying to do Memory Master, they have to do the flashcards, the whole deck, 15 times 15. So you're gonna need to really pick up that pace. But besides Memory Master, guys, if you're watching this and you don't do CC, it's just really important for kids to know their math facts. It's gonna be so useful to them as they go further and further into math. And if they are getting hung up on a math fact and can't even proceed in the math problem because they don't know their math fact, or they have to use some little gimmick or, you know, Common Core making you draw these pictures, you're gonna be so slowed down. And aren't kids gonna generally kind of hate math? You know, math generally gets a bad rap. It's going to get an even worse rap if it's just taking so much longer because they don't know their facts. So it's a really worthy goal to help your kids memorize their math facts. And I hope that I have been clear. If you have questions, please ask. I like to answer your questions. And if I realize that I wasn't clear, then I will remake this video for you because I really do want to help people memorize their facts well and really see that for the valuable thing that it is. And it's kind of a gift that you can give your kids when they're young and their ability to memorize is so good. So you can get them to memorize them, then they have them in their pocket for when they proceed with math. It's there, and they will do so much better in math if you can equip them in this way. So let me know if you have any questions, and have a great day.